With the abundance of rain and unusually mild temperatures this spring, we've seen plants growing by leaps and bounds in very short time spans. And as all that rainfall percolates through the soil, soluble minerals move with it, washing essential plant nutrients below the root zone, putting them out of reach at a time when plants need more of them than usual. While native plants are more accustomed to our natural weather patterns and more accustomed to the natural level of nutrients in our soil to begin with, adapted ornamentals may struggle a bit with these swings and need a supplemental boost in spring. Nutrient deficiencies manifest in very particular patterns, making it relatively easy for astute gardeners to course correct with a bit of fertilizer before things get too out of whack. There's no shortage of products to choose from, including many fertilizers that are naturally derived. But before you apply any product, even an organic one, indiscriminately, you need to know just exactly which nutrients your plant needs. Most nutrient deficiencies manifest as some sort of yellowing, which we refer to as chlorosis. And while there are over 20 essential plant nutrients, plants require most of them in such minute amounts that only a handful will ever be so low in the soil as to cause any issues. Also, plants can move some of these nutrients around within their own bodies, buying time for the external environment to improve. Because of this, some nutrient deficiencies, such as nitrogen, will manifest in older leaves while new leaves appear healthy. But other deficiencies, such as iron deficiency, will manifest on new leaves because plants aren't able to move iron around once they've incorporated it into their tissues. Nitrogen is the nutrient needed by plants in the highest quantities, so it's the most common nutrient in fertilizers. Iron deficiency is very common for gardeners in the western U.S., where soil pH tends towards the alkaline side, and it manifests as interveinal chlorosis, yellowing of the leaves between the green veins on new leaves. Unfortunately, putting nails in your garden to correct iron deficiency doesn't work, and before you buy any product, be sure to consult with your local county extension office or nursery professional to make sure you've correctly diagnosed the issue. Early spring wildflower seeds, including bluebonnets, should be getting dry and brown enough to clip if you want to save some seeds. Remove the seeds from the pods and let them dry completely in the house before storing. Plant in October and November. KLRU's Vice President of Education, Benjamin Kramer, and his family planted bluebonnets last fall in their yard. As a nod to CTG producer Linda Lemishferta, they named them Linda Bluebonnets. What a fun family project, and she's certainly proud to have a bluebonnet named for her. From Carrollton, Monica and Daryl Miller are celebrating their first hydrangea bloom. They're growing this beauty in a container in part shade on their patio where it's obviously thriving. We'd love to hear from you. Visit centraltexasgardener.org to share your stories, pictures, and videos.